a little bit different this weekend, but one thing remains the same, and that's our reporter down there on the floor, Miss Christy Lee.
Thanks, Robbie. Well, this is the first weekend we haven't seen a doubleheader this season. Normally, we see races on both Friday and Saturday, but there was no racing last night. Now, tonight's format won't change, but there's a lot of pressure on our riders. With less time on the track, less laps turned, less points up for grabs, Robbie, I expect tonight's competition to be even tighter.
I think you're exactly right, Christy, but one thing we know is the dominance of Bowers. Why has he been so strong? 12 main events, 9 main event wins.
He's won from pole position outside second row. I mean, it doesn't matter what they do. This guy is riding on a high. He's confident. He's strong. He's aggressive. And he puts himself in a position to win every time.
Looking for that race to the championship, the first 6 events. We re-rag them, restack them after the Wilkes-Barre event. And then that back 4, you've got to be in that top 10. If you're not in the top 10, if you're Bowers down to Genopi, you're looking good. Outside that, you better pick up the pace.
Well, Robbie Marshall slipped out of the top 10 due to injury, but right behind him even, we got, Stephen Majors, Kyle White, Michael Willett. These guys, now is the time to get it going because you only got a few more rounds to get in that top 10. That's where you need to be in for a chance at that championship.
You're exactly right. Well, let's take a look at this track through the rider's eyes. It looks a lot like last week here in Tulsa. It's Daniel Blair with a GoPro track preview.
Down the start straightaway. Into the first turn, you can bank off the wall. Get yourself a run at the whoops. Real good set of whoops this week. Triple in the rhythm. I'm not gonna do it right now because I haven't done it yet today. Rail the last corner. Hit the catapults a little smaller this week. Turn it up. And on to the start straight.
Thank you, Daniel Blair. This is the Amsoil Arena Cross featuring Ricky Carmichael's Road to Supercross. And boy, when Ricky Carmichael puts his name on the event, you know he's proud of it. I was able to sit down and talk to him earlier.
The Ricky Carmichael Road to Supercross was something that I worked with Fell Motorsports with for about a year now to try to help these younger kids coming up from the amateur series to go through the Arena Cross series and hone their skills in a little bit and improve to someday eventually be able to race a Monster Energy Supercross series. I think it's a great series to learn in because, the Amsoil Arena Cross series is extremely tough. These guys are really talented. It is as close to Supercross as you can get, and the level of competitiveness that is out here is unbelievable. It's cool how we came up with this concept, the Ricky Carmichael Road to Supercross, is no matter how much practice you do in the off season when you're 16 years old and you're gonna make your debut in Supercross, I don't care how many laps you turn, nothing simulates being in that moment in an enclosed environment. And that's why I believe they need to go through the Arena Cross series. You have these young guys coming up that all they want to do is race Monster Energy Supercross. Don't underestimate these cats in Arena Cross because they are legit at what they do. They are the best in the business, and it's not going to be a walk in the park, but the event in general is a great learning curve, I believe, if you want to be at the main stage. I think it's a great program for the future. I think 2 or 3 years from now, we'll really be seeing the benefits from it.
Good to sit down and talk to the champ. We'll hear more from him later. And when we come back, it's Amsoil Arena Cross Heat Race number 1. By the BOK Center, preparing for Heat Race number 1 of the Arena Cross class. This is simple, an 8-lap race, trying to make yourself in that top 7 to move on to the final. If you're in the top 4, you go to the head-to-head bracket race a little bit later on. Let's take a look at our K&N starting grid. Tyler Bowers, our top qualifier. Steve Majors, another guy to look for. David Genopi, we talked about him in the open, how he's right there on that bubble. He's looking for a good result here.
Well, it looks like he's putting in a good effort to start the day off.
Who's going to get the first hole shot of the night all the way to the outside? Kawasaki.
Garrett Steinke. But Tyler Bowers just comes up the inside of the whoops, man. Just carrying more speed in there.
Deep bounces, showing you how to triple. That's the fastest way through that rhythm section. A very similar track to what we saw in the last round of Amsoil Arena Cross. And unfortunately for the rest of the field, Tyler Bowers is already out in front.
Well, that's the last thing any of these guys want to see because, like we said, he's showing us he's pretty dominant. The chances of him throwing this away are highly unlikely. But like we've been saying, these guys know that they need to start picking up the pace and taking it to them.
You see the two lines there. Stephen Majes just behind the motorsport.com KTM trying to put his way into second to get by Steinke. Steinke not qualifying so well early on. One of our front runners early on this season.
Well, yeah, I mean, obviously a good start helps as we see Majes coming in with a little more momentum, but he's got the inside. Beautifully excellent block pass and still makes a 3-3 coming out through that rhythm. So not only did he make the pass, he gaps himself so he doesn't have to play defense.
Good run there, working our way through the field. Top four go to the head-to-head bracket. David Genofi, number 14, back and forth. There is, it looks like Kyle White had some problems just a minute ago. But Stephen Majes in second. See if he can make up some time on Tyler Ballard.
I'm curious to see what happens right now because he's got a clear track, but while watching him, he actually looks very comfortable, very confident, and you know, visibly the gap between him and Bowers is staying kind of similar, and even looking at their last lap times, 0.2 of a difference. Bowers slightly faster, but not having that runaway victory like we've seen at some of these events. So a nice surprise to see Majes, you know, hanging in tough.
Working on lap number 6 of 8. And the whoop section a little bit shorter this time. You almost had that pre-jump heading into it, not the full long whoop section we've seen already this year.
Exactly. What it is with that little jump coming in is you want to kind of soak the bike up so that you don't want to land in the whoops. You want to have the suspension offload so you go into those whoops light, like you're trying to, like a stone skimming across water. You want to just stay low, flat. Watch Bowers. He soaks it up with his legs and lets that strong upper body take care of the rest. Little lap traffic there, making him unable to go 3-3.
Hey, that's a champion.
Yeah.
Instead of pushing that point or trying to run around him on the outside, what could have happened?
He played it safe. And unfortunately, out of the shot, it took down Stephen Majes. So our second place rider went down. And then, that's one of those things you just cannot control in this racing, is, you know, what other people do. Bowers now singling that section with the yellow flag out, with the rider still down. So now that moves Garrett Steinke back up into second place. Dave Genofi third. Tyler Villopoto sitting there solidly in fourth. So he's looking at going to the bracket racing. Chad Cook, Stephen Majes able to keep it in the qualifying position. And Willie Browning rounding out the top 7.
Steinke now starting to step up. And Tyler Villopoto, first time we've really seen him up in the front in that top four. He's been in the head-to-head one time so far, as the white flag is out. The last lap for this heat race number one. The Babbitt Kawasaki out in front. The Babbitt Monster Energy Amsoil Kawasaki, two-time defending champion.
Look at Villopoto. He's looking very racy tonight.
Trying to step his way, trying to get inside Dave Genofi, but nobody can touch Tyler Bowers. Just behind him, Garrett Steinke, Genofi, and Villopoto will go to that head-to-head matchup.
A great racing. That was super tight at the end there. And Kyle White, unfortunately, looking in from the outside.
And looking at the Heat 1 results, Chad Cook, Stephen Majes, and Willie Browning also transferred to the final. Kyle White has to ride the LCQ. Let's go down to our winner on the podium.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, Tyler Grant up here in the booth, man. You look super solid once again. It seemed like the only close call you had was with a lapper. Did it catch you off guard?
Man, there's guys everywhere out there tonight. I don't know what's going on. I think it's getting a little slick out there again. Practice was really tacky, so I don't know what's going on with guys out there, but there was guys going down everywhere, and I just tried to stay out of the carnage.
Good job, man. You did that very well. Good luck in the main event tonight.
Hey, thanks a lot, guys.
We'll also see him in the head-to-head matchup. Tyler Bowers wins heat race number one. When we come back to Tulsa, we'll see heat race number two.
So this performance...
The fans are pumped here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Before we get ready for heat race number two, let's go down to Christy Lee.
Well, we just finished up heat one. Here we are with heat two. You can see who's on the front row. Well, they're all on the front row. But let's talk behind the scenes for just a moment. Number 17, Daniel Blair, coming off an injury from last weekend. He said if he could ride last weekend, he was definitely racing this weekend. Number 5, Kelly Smith, just flew in today with a delay on his plane due to the weather. And number 16, Mike McDade, has a lot of ground to make up from last weekend. He's running a one-man show this weekend without a mechanic, no crew, just a friend here to help him out. It's going to be a great race.
Thanks, Chrissy. As we take a look at the Thor starting grid, Mike McDade, our top qualifier for the heat qualifiers earlier today, Zach Ames, Lance Vincent, a couple of guys to look for. This heat race, it's got to be tough, like Chrissy talked about, when you fly in last second, when you don't have a mechanic. How do you kind of get that out of your mind?
You know, it's like anything. It's just you got to deal with it like a professional. Nothing is always going to go as the plan.
And a good start from Kelly Smith. He flies in late or not. The number five is out in front, hitting the whoops hard. But look to the inside. Oh, a little bit of the Yahoo effect from the number 16 of Mike McDade.
McDade, they're coming in the whoops with a full head of steam, wrestling that number two spot away. It's Kelly Smith, like we just said, he came in late. You got to be a professional, man, and pick it up. And that's exactly what he's done. Like, he may have flown in late, but he flew into the first turn. As you see, they're banking off that side of that arena. But that's standard now, I've noticed. These guys are using the side of the stadium for traction.
Yeah, but it's not a photo shoot. You're not trying to see how flat you can lay it in that turn. Almost got a little bit too flat with those nylon dashers. This is inside a hockey arena. They didn't flare the walls out or anything. That far side in that first turn is hockey arena walls.
So you don't want to mess with them, because we've seen what happens if you come in a little too hot. As we see Michael McDade now going 3-3. Obviously, he's a better mechanic than I ever will be, because his bike's running great.
Just behind these two, a good battle goes on between Corey Green and the number four of Zach Ames. You see the yellow just behind McDade. Up front, these two, they've been racing with each other, but it's the first time we've seen Corey Green this season. McDade doesn't look like he can stay on top of the whoops quite right.
You know, I don't know if part of that is just intentional, because it looks to me like he actually sort of wheel taps the last three so he doesn't get kicked, you know, onto the front wheel. Coming out, he looks up the inside. Oh, I don't know if Kelly Smith expected him. He looked like he got a fright, but beautifully done. Nice, solid pass. Let's see if he can counteract in the whoops here.
Hello, how you doing? You notice how he takes that left-hand side, yeah, trying to guard that inside.
That's smart. You know, that's what a smart rider does. He knows, hey, I've just passed this guy. He wants to counterattack immediately. Close that door. Don't give him that chance.
Quick eight-lap heat races. One name you do not see in there is Jeff Gibson on the KTM. His wife, Chanel, had a daughter, had their daughter this week. He said, I'm taking a round off, family first, and we'll see you next week at Cedar Park.
Well, yeah, absolutely. That's awesome. It's his first, so we want to congratulate the whole Gibson family.
Also, Addie Lynn, his new daughter. Corey Green finished 10th in the series last year, now drops back to fourth, the number 480. You see him, Zach Ames, now starting to work his way up into third, starting to put the pressure on Kelly Smith.
But he's on the outside here, so that doesn't help him too much, as he has to, you know, sand it up. And unfortunately, not able to go 3-3, so not only does he not make the pass, he loses a couple of bike lengths. So now he's got to do that all over again. Let's see what he can do, as the battle still rages on behind these guys.
Mike McDade checking out of this one, the number five, the motorsport. The number five just behind it. Is it? It's actually, yeah, Nathan Skaggs I was thinking about in the number two position. Or no, I have Kelly Smith or Skaggs. Which one is in this heat race?
That's Kelly Smith in second, coming under pressure from Zach Ames now. Ames closed that couple bike length lead up. Let's see. Kelly Smith doing the smart thing, kind of going to the inside. Ames almost having to follow him. Can he go three again? Yep, Ames didn't want to miss it, knowing that he would lose valuable ground again.
I'm starting to get old man eyes. The number six of Nathan Skaggs trying to work his way in that top seven, now up to six. We're on the white flag lap, signifying last lap in this heat race number two. McDade and Smith, spotlight is on your leader with one rider to his outside. Look at the race just behind in second with Kelly Smith and Zach Ames, with the white flag turns to checkered, and Mike McDade takes heat race number two, followed by Kelly Smith, Zach Ames, and Lance Vincent, number 87, going to that head-to-head matchup. As we take a look at the Rocky Mountain ATV results, Corey Green, Nathan Skaggs, Brandon Glenn, they also move into the final. Michael Willard, Daniel Blair have to ride the last chance qualifier. That should be a good one. Let's go down to Mosaitis Motorsports. Michael McDade, congratulations on that heat race victory.
Thanks, guys. It was the track was awesome. It was nice and tacky and also slick, but it works good for me. The whoops are great, and I'm glad to be up here.
Hey, Michael Grant here. After a disappointing race weekend last weekend, which was unfortunate, it seems like you're on a man on a mission tonight. How are you feeling out there?
Yeah, last weekend was a bummer, but you know, it happens once in a while, and I'm happy to be here, and the bike's running great, and I have my dad here, and it's good to have everybody here and everybody support me. And you know, this doesn't matter right now, so when it does start to count, you know, at least it's out of the way now.
You ready for the head-to-head matchup?
Can't wait.
All right, it's about to go down. Thanks a lot, Mike McDade. We'll see him in the head-to-head as well as the main events. That's your Heat Race 2 winner, Mike McDade. When we return, the head-to-head about to take off.
Alka-Seltzer Plus.
Back to the BOK Center, Robbie Floyd, Grant Langston with you as we prepare for the head-to-head matchup. It's a bracket race. The top four qualifiers from Heat 1, Heat 2, they go at it head-to-head for one valuable championship point.
Absolutely, and we've said it before, man, this is some of the best racing we see because it's a head-to-head matchup, ball-banging guys just going for it. Someone's going to get a valuable point, and at this stage of the series, every point counts, so let's see what happens.
It's a two-lap sprint. Let's kick things off with round two action. Mike McDade knocked off David Genofi. Kelly Smith knocked off Tyler Villopoto in the first round. This should be a good matchup. Again, we talked about both of these guys. One's wrenching on his own bike. The other showed up at the last minute today.
Might be a blessing in disguise. They both look pretty good tonight. Kelly with a great jump, getting that power to the ground.
It's the second time McDade didn't get the whole shot, but made the pass.
And he's on the inside now, so that'd be good. Whoa. And Kelly counteract.
Got a little squirrely.
Plays it smart.
And Kelly's able to triple, so he's going to look better on the back end of this.
But Michael McDade actually was able to go 2-3 in the middle, so he didn't lose anything there. Kelly looks up the inside, but no. Oh, and McDade rail sliding down the start straight.
It's only a two-lap race. It is a sprint, a mad sprint. And McDade a little slow here. Kelly's going to close in. Oh. One more straightaway.
You better hug this inside,
yeah,
because if he leaves it open.
You better lean on it. Not enough. Donut for KS Kelly Smith, and Mike McDade moves on to the next round. Monster Energy, Babbitt's, Kawasaki, they're going to win this either way. Tyler Bowers, who knocked off Lance Vincent, and Zach Ames, who defeated Jarrett Steinke in the previous round. And I like how whoever got first gate pick, the other guy said, I'm getting right up in your grill, buddy.
Oh, yeah, and usually just on the inside so that if they get the jump, they control that first turn.
Look at
the photo in the background.
He's trying to
mimicking
time the
a
game.
Start. Oh, nice jump there from Tyler, and immediately goes to the inside,
protects it. Rails it.
Wow, what a gutsy call now, around the outside.
Now can he shut it down? Lean in. Now Bowers.
Super tight. Ames.
What's Ames going to do? He can't do it. He had to double in.
Tyler kind of like chopped the angle down in that corner, so.
You have defensive driving. This is defensive racing. It's like playing tag with your buddy. And these are two very good friends and teammates, and Ames going to have a good run on the outside. Bowers has nowhere. Oh, and he slides.
But he was unable to triple, but he triples in the middle. Bowers keeps it clean and takes the victory. You can tell their teammates and roommates that was good, hard racing, but no real contact.
In the bracket race final, Mike McDade, Tyler Bowers go head-to-head. Five main event wins in a row for Tyler Bowers, but he's been on a bad streak as far as the head-to-head bracket racing. He's lost the last two he's been in. McDade to 16.
Oh, and he hits the gate.
This is going to be even better.
That couldn't have worked out any better there for Michael. I mean, he's got the lead, but the problem is when Bowers is right behind you, you've got to ride defensive.
Now
which is exactly what he did, hug the inside through the whoops.
Both of them double up, so they're going to be side by side. Neither wanted to triple out. You just got to keep Bowers at it outside.
They're very smartly played. Like, this is like a game of defense right here.
Chasing it.
Oh!
It's tag.
That's it. Little bump and run.
Don't count him out. I said don't count him out, and I was not expecting that.
What a bummer. You know what?
I think I can see Tyler smiling in his helmet from here.
Well, he did that as well, but that's why this is so cool, this kind of racing, man. Like, these guys just go at it as Tyler takes the win and the point.
Oh, man, he gets the snide, gets that monkey off his back. Bowers still waiting for Mike McDade to cross that finish line, but finally he gets another head-to-head matchup victory. Well, that's going to be it for Tyler Bowers until the main events. We still have plenty more action here from Tulsa, Oklahoma. It's the BOK Center and the fourth stop of Amsoil Arena Cross. We'll be back with more.
One, two.
There he is, the man, Ricky Carmichael, RC4, the greatest of all time at Amsoil Arena Cross. Just a special part of each and every week's festivities. You get to walk the track in the track walk, get to see what these riders are riding on, meet the rider, get his autograph, get a picture with him. At each and every stop, you've got to come out. It's just another part that makes Amsoil Arena Cross so special. The DC Shoes refuse to lose. Last chance qualifier, only two move on to the main event, and there's more than two guys that are capable of moving on to the main.
Somebody's going to be an unhappy camper by the end of the evening. I'm looking at the lineup here, the top three, Willard, White, Blair, all with a chance.
You need the start. It looks like a Honda, possibly Kyle White. But
Willard
that's
up
not
the inside.
The case. Number nine of Willard on the inside. It was a 5-5-1 who had a good start. Sizemore, but he works his way back through the pack. And Daniel Blair moves up into second. So two of the guys that we thought would be up there, Kyle White not getting the start. He needs back and forth. He's got to move on. This is a very quick race, another only eight-lap race.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, fourth place, there's no need to panic. We just completed one lap, but get yourself in a position. Move yourself to third, keep in touch, and hope that on the last lap, possibly you can make a
and
toss.
And now that race in third, fourth, that's the one you kind of need to be looking for, is Willard starting to separate himself. Daniel Blair in second. That race for third and fourth starting to heat up just behind them. You got to get in the top two in this LCQ.
And for Kyle White, who's now made the pass and moved into third place, this is critical for him to get in the main event tonight, because he is sitting 12th in points. Not to forget, Robbie Marshall, who's in front of him, is actually injured and not even here. Tonight is an opportunity for Kyle White to put himself in that position to fight for the championship and be in that top 10.
You're seeing Willard as well as Blair, but really the hard charger just behind him. He keeps sneaking into the picture. Is the number 19 of Kyle White. Willard, pretty strong. I think he's got this one in hand. It's that race for second.
Willard has a look over his shoulder, but Kyle White now closing up on Daniel Blair. This is going to get interesting. And look at the side of the stadium. They've plowed it so hard. I don't know what that is, some shrapnel coming off the side.
Look at the difference between also the lines coming through that first turn. The rider in the front of your picture, 17, Daniel Blair. He's in the main event as it stands right now. The 19 just behind him has to move up one more position.
As we look at the near the front here, Michael Willard still holding on to that first place and a very valuable position to be in.
Oh,
Kyle White creeping up on Blair. That's what I said. There was no need to panic in the beginning, but you get close. Oh, he paces it. That hurt him. Look at that. He lost several bike lengths there. Time's running out.
Safe to say Kyle White's faster in the whoops. Let's look at this one more time. Again, the 19 outside looking in. Watch him through the whoops. See if he can close in, taking more middle of the road.
See, hikes that inside. Yeah, he's changing it up a little bit.
There it is.
That main line.
Look at him close in.
Gaining some ground, but he can't do that 3-3. Keeps tagging it, going triple, double, single, and he loses. Look, just a little bit of valuable time.
Last lap, Willard's going to do it if he keeps it on two wheels. The Advocare bike of Daniel Blair in second. This is where it's important. Watch out, a lap rider in front of him.
What's going to happen? They come in side by side, but he's on the outside. Can he go 3-3?
He did it that time.
Did he get the second three and to the inside?
Stuff.
No!
And he
does
take
a bump
it.
And run.
And Blair goes down. What a race. Kyle White takes
it. Did he ghost his bike at him?
At the last second. No, Daniel just lost it to the outside. Willard totally oblivious of what happened behind him.
Let's take another look at that. Kyle White dives up the inside of Daniel Blair. They make contact as Blair runs out of road. Ghost rides his bike into the side of Kyle White, but Kyle White goes to the main.
So everything looks to be okay for Daniel Blair, except for his night is done here in Tulsa. That's what the live event, that's what AMSOIL Arena Cross is all about, and we still have the main events to go. Stick with us.
The Asphalt Gladiator.
Welcome back to AMSOIL Arena Cross from the BOK Center. It is time for the main event, and let's take a quick look at the Monster Energy starting grid. This is going to be a good one with our top qualifier, Mike McDade, Tyler Bowers, Kelly Smith, working our way through the field. We have 16 riders ready to hit this main event number one for 12 laps. A fair start by Bowers. He's going to get shut down, but it looks like Kelly Smith with a great start on the outside, number five on the Team Faith KTM.
Bowers slipped straight into second there with a couple of cowies behind him. His teammate Zach Ames, I believe, in third, and Michael McDade in fourth. So all the big hitters are near the front at the moment.
Kelly Smith has a little hello. I'm Tyler Bowers coming through. Now Tyler takes over the lead. The Babbitts, Monster Energy, Amsoil, Kawasaki showing how to get it done after one lap, takes the lead and shows how strong he is through that whoop section.
But Kelly Smith not giving up just yet. If you look right behind, there's a freight train. These guys are still nose to tail. One little bobble from any of these guys.
Oh, and Ames
tucks the front end, trying to sneak underneath Kelly Smith. Just getting on some of that shiny, greasy stuff over there. And unfortunately, just a little tip over, but enough to cost him a bunch of ground.
That helps Mike McDade back in third. Again, Ames and McDade only separated by one championship point. Second and third place, both following Tyler Bowers, the number one. This is a guy who is on a 5 main event win streak, looking to make it 6 here. But Kelly Smith, we've seen the past few weeks, if anybody's going to mock him off, it's probably him, because he's been doing this rhythm section probably stronger than anyone.
Yeah, he's just been hitting it very consistently. We saw last week it was very similar, but I would say a little more difficult because a lot of guys weren't able to do it consistently. He's looking pretty good lately, and it's like anything in sport. Once you get that momentum and that confidence, it's a great thing to have, man, I'm telling you.
4 laps in the books, about to make that number 5. This is a 12-lap main event. Main event number 1, the same guys get to restack for main event number 2. Whoever wins this race gets to draw a suitcase and say, hey, are we going to invert no riders, 8 riders, or 16 riders? And there's Mike McDade in third, trying to close in on the 5 of Kelly Smith.
As a lap rider down there, guys having to square up that firm and stay out of it. But another guy who you mentioned earlier is looking good tonight, Corey Green, still sitting there in that 4th position, but he's been hanging tough all night long. Pretty impressive, this guy, so far.
There's McDade, there's Green on the yellow Suzuki just behind, having to work on his own bike. Said maybe it's his good luck charm. Said dad's doing his stuff this weekend. You had your dad around a lot in your racing career.
In the beginning, my dad was my riding coach, my driver, my mechanic, my trainer. I mean, he was everything, and you know, until it gets to that level where, you know, the factory teams take over.
There's the 480, Corey Green, Oklahoma rider, been very strong. You see him on that bright yellow Suzuki. Not, you know, doesn't have any pressure on him from behind. He's actually trying to close in on McDade. He's no stranger to arena cross. We've seen him, but it's our first time to see him this year.
Yeah, and first time I've got to see this guy ride in person. And he's a local boy, you know, probably very comfortable. Probably got a lot of friends and family out here supporting him. So this is awesome to see a guy like this having a solid ride. And if you're going to have a good ride, you want to do it in front of your fans.
Yeah, when you look at his score sheet, no sponsors list. You see with the answer gear. Hey, guys, you need to kick down some. It may be a clerical error on his part, but anytime you don't see sponsors, this guy needs a little more love. He's fast. He's in the top 5 at Amsoil Arena Cross, ahead of Tyler Villopoto, who won the lights main event just a few moments ago.
As we switch back to the front here, Bowers coming through some lap traffic. Jared Steinke, of all people.
And the next guy in front of Tyler Bowers is his teammate who keeps having problems, Zach Ames, number 4.
That's a bummer for Zach. You know, maybe got a little impatient in the beginning. As we see the spotlight on Tyler Bowers, that means nothing. The last lap, riders down, carnage everywhere. But he knows he's got a gap. He could just play it safe as he's coming up. Michael Willard right in front of him. He does a smart veteran move, moves to the side.
Race for seconds, tightened up, but number 1 is going to go to Tyler Bowers. That's 6 in a row for the Babbitts Kawasaki. Second comes to the checker flag at the last second. Kelly Smith able to hold on over Mike McDade. But it's the Tyler Bowers show in main event number 1. Looking at the main event results for main event number 1, Tyler Bowers, Kelly Smith, McDade, Corey Green, very impressive. Villopoto, the first time we've seen him in the top 5, but look through the field, a strong finish. Kyle White finishing in the top 10. One guy out of that top 10 is Tyler Bowers' teammate, Zach Ames. Let's go down with Christy Lee and the winner, Tyler Bowers.
Thanks, Robbie. Tyler, great race, another win. That makes 6 for you. Congrats.
Yeah, thanks a lot. You know, I got off to a good start, and I just tried to stay out of trouble. You know, there's guys everywhere out there. I got my C4 engines out working good. You know, Frenchie's building our motors. I got a good start, so that's the key now, man. It's only 12 laps long. You got to get out to a good start and try to run away. And, you know, my team, Babbitt's, Monster Energy, Amsoil, Kawasaki, is it's the tool for the win.
Let's talk about the invert. Now, you picked the number 8. Well, actually, Ricky Carmichael picked the number 8 for you. How do you feel having your fate in someone else's hands? And do you think maybe he rigged that?
I don't know. I think he knew that was my least favorite one. But tonight, you know, I always feel like the crowd knows something because they're really quiet on 0 for some reason. Always the case that ends up being 0. They never cheer for it, but and I always go with the crowd. But tonight, I picked up the cases and put them on the stand, and you know, they led Ricky to that number 8, which is my least favorite. I'd rather 16 or 0, but we're gonna make do with it. Get out there and try to get a good start, and try to race real hard and get the win still.
Best of luck.
Congratulations, Tyler Bowers. Ricky Carmichael picks the number 8, so Tyler's gonna get the last pick on that front row, and we'll talk to RC when we come back. More Amsoil Arena Cross from Tulsa. Welcome back to Amsoil Arena Cross featuring Ricky Carmichael's Road to Supercross. Who better to talk to than Ricky Carmichael himself? Glad to have you at Arena Cross. What do you think, first impression?
Oh, I am really, really impressed. I'm going to tell you what, the Amsoil Arena Cross has been awesome tonight. I mean, just the whole experience for me. This is my first time attending one, and it's been awesome. I mean, the bracket race, and even watching the little 50cc guys have been fun. The heat races were really, really entertaining. I tell you what, I can't believe it. I'm kind of in shock.
It's different, though, Grant, don't you think? I mean, the first time you see, when you go to a live event, it's an experience. You get to be a part of it, but, yeah. I mean, it's tighter than it looks on TV, and it looks pretty darn tight on TV.
Well, you know, until I had been, yeah, I felt the same way like Ricky just said. I had no idea just how entertaining this was, and, you know, with the new format and with having Ricky involved, it's really brought new life. I really enjoy this. You know, it's been so cool having everyone a part of it. And the racing's just been amazing. I love the bracket racing. And even in the LCQs, we see some desperate Dan last lap maneuvers, but it's been awesome.
Well, let's talk about Tyler Bowers. How strong? I mean, right now he's looking a lot like you were back in your Supercross days. What can you say to this guy? I mean, right now he's dominating here. He's loving this series. He's doing about everything he can right now.
Yeah, well, I think Grant could attest to this. I mean, just ride it out as long as you can. That's what it's all about. Rack those wins up, rack those titles up. And, you know, he's definitely found his niche. You know, he's probably making a great living at doing it. It looks like he's having a lot of fun. And at the end of the day, that's what it's all about. And, you know, he doesn't have to race too long. And the fans really have accepted him as the champion. And he needs to take that role and continue to grow and grow and grow. And it's only going to be good for him and the Arena Cross Series.
Well, Grant's offered advice. Several guys come up and talk to him. He's a world champion like yourself. You know, what do you say to Tyler Bowers of how he can go faster out there? Because I know you've got that racing mind right now. Where do you think these guys can pick up a little speed?
Well, you know, that's a great question because I had a chance to ride in practice today. And I'm going to tell you, it's almost you have to race smarter in Arena Cross than you do in the Monster Energy Supercross because the track is so much smaller. So you can't to go faster, you need
down.
To back up a little bit. To go faster, and me and Tyler were talking about that after practice. You know, it's all about setup, and things happen so quick, and everything's so tight. You have to be thinking, ahead. So that's really what you got to do is take a step back to go faster. I believe.
Okay, I've got a couple of retired guys. Maybe we can see you before the year's out. Maybe a head-to-head matchup. Maybe a two-lap
no,
main event.
No. We're good. What we're doing right now, I think.
All right, it's good to have Ricky Carmichael on board. This is the road to the Supercross. This is the way you do it. Amsoil Arena Cross. We'll be back with more main event number 2 when we return.
I have my own.
Amsoil Arena Cross main event number 2 about to get underway. The Monster Energy starting grid. We invert the top 8 riders, and most notably, the number 7 is staying on the front row because the number 1 rider, who should have 8th pick, moves to the back row inside. Tyler Bowers says, "Forget that front. I'm in inside back."
Yeah, we can't see him quite on the shot, but he's right behind Green on the yellow Suzuki on the inside. There's Bowers in the background. Let's see how this pans out for him. Was it a smart decision or not? Great start by McDade. You see the bike skating into that turn, and he holds on. Oh, tough blocks flying everywhere.
And Bowers in 5th place coming out of the whoop. But Mike McDade with a whole shot. Can he check out?
Let's make that 4th place now. This guy doesn't waste any time, does he?
Mike McDade, the number 16. He ran a 3-digit number earlier in the year. He's in the top 10 of points. He finished 16th. Last year. He's currently 3rd in points this year. We talked about how Corey Green, no sponsors listed at all, but this kid is fast with Tyler Bowers now moving into 3rd.
As
Now, this is an opportunity. Bowers is making quick work of these guys. He's now coming up with Corey Green. This is the chance for Michael McDade to steal a little bit of momentum and a little bit of confidence if he can win this.
Tyler Bowers with his teammate, who he just got by, Tyler Villopoto, back and forth after winning the lights main event. A strong ride by Corey Green on the Suzuki there. Bowers checking out. He's already got a differential of almost 2.9 seconds.
Hey, he's making a run for it. He's knowing he's got to go. He's got to gap the field because McDade knows that sooner or later he's going to see that big number one behind him.
I don't know. The rate he's going right now, and he has clean track ahead of him, he may be able to pull this out. And you also see Tyler Bowers, he's moved into third, but now
nice setup.
He makes that pass.
He is so good at those passes. He can do them now without having to make any contact, but he's just making it smart that they can't cut underneath them or go the long way around. So he's being very defensive and smart about it.
When Bowers got by Corey Green on that last lap or on this lap, heading into the whoops, McDade was exiting. So a full straightaway lead for Mike McDade. Let's see what happens in another five laps.
Well, the nice thing if you're Michael McDade is this is not exactly the longest of races. And if you're Tyler Bowers, you're not pumped because it is a short race and you might not have enough time.
We're looking at it overall as well. Mike McDade in that first main event, third place. Tyler Bowers taking the win. If he's in second right now, we should still give him the overall with that extra point he got from the head-to-head matchup.
Absolutely. A couple riders having a little bit of trouble. Kyle White, 15th, he slid out. Garrett Steinke, he having a crash of his own. So those guys are, in fact, Steinke about to be lapped by our leader, Michael McDade. So not the greatest of nights for Steinke. He's struggled a little bit with some mistakes.
No mistakes for the 16, taking that very inside drastic line. There's no more room to go left.
Yeah.
He must really like it, because if he goes left another 6 inches, he's hitting a wall of dirt.
Well, you know, the one good thing, I guess, is because no one's really going there, that line doesn't change up very much. So he knows what to expect. And that's the thing with riders. A lot of times they'll take a line just because they know what to expect and they're comfortable with it. And he is making it work for him. And he's unable to triple out of that turn because of some lap traffic. But Tyler Bowers maybe inching up a couple bike lengths through that. So the lap traffic could play into
Tyler Bowers. Steinke both pull over for Tyler Bowers. McDade had to fight his way through both of them, and that full straightaway lead is not that much anymore, less than a half a straightaway.
And that's what I was about to say, Robbie, is the leader has a disadvantage because he's the first guy coming up on the lap, and so they sometimes don't know. So when he gets around, they look over their shoulder and go, oh, there's Tyler Bowers, let me move out of the way. So it's a little trickier when you're out front.
Only a couple of laps left. Bowers hits the whoops as McDade just in front of him has two more riders just in front looking to slow him down. Villopoto back and forth just behind Corey Green, but the race for third as
he
the white
makes
flag
the
comes
pass.
Out.
He passes. Tyler Villopoto gets around Corey Green there, right? As you said that, as we start the last lap as the white flag comes out.
McDade looking for no bobbles again. Tyler Bowers looking for the overall, but McDade wants his main event win. 16 points for main event. White goes to checkered, and Mike McDade takes another victory in Amsoil Arena Cross. Tyler Bowers starts on the second row and will finish second. A strong run by Tyler Villopoto, the best we've seen him all year. Bowers' teammate in third. We'll be back and talk to these guys. Mike McMahon, you know he has a smile on his face. Tyler Bowers, the streak has ended. We'll hear from him when we return.
This is
looking at the overall results for the night. Tyler Bowers almost unbeatable, but Mike McDade was able to do it in that second main event. Villopoto finishes third. Green, Vincent Smith looking down through the field. Zach Ames, 10th overall. That's going to hurt him in points. But his teammate smiling. Tyler Bowers does it again on top of the podium. He's with Christy Lee.
Tyler, that's 6 out of 7 overall wins for you this season. What's your secret?
You know, getting off to good starts and just trying to stay up. You know, stay out of the carnage. There's a lot of stuff going on out there. And, you know, this is basically a game. And I got my C4 Racing engines getting me to the front of the pack right off the bat. Frenchie LeDuc's doing our motors this year, and they're great, you know. You know, my team Babbitt's, Monster Energy, Amsoil Kawasaki is getting us to the front. And the whole crew behind me is helping me out a lot. My mechanic, Junior Jackson. I couldn't do it without the support of everybody. But, like I said, just getting to the front of the pack and trying to stay off the ground. And out in the second model here, I I went to the second row instead of outside on the first row, and you know, it came out pretty good. I just had to shove some guys around and come out clean rather than pinned to the wall somewhere, and try to get my team Babbitt's Monster Energy AMSL Kawasaki on top.
What can we look forward to in Cedar Park?
Hopefully a lot of the same. You know, I'm gonna go back home. I was sick all this week, so I'm gonna go back home and try to stay on the track and prepare, and hopefully Cedar Park can get a lot of the same.
So the man who trails Tyler Bowers is Michael McDade, now in the overall points. A solid finish tonight and finishes second overall, and Chrissy's with him.
Tough weekend last weekend for you, Mike, but it looked to be a tough weekend without a mechanic, without a crew operating, with just a friend here. You had your dad here in support, but obviously that's all you needed.
Yeah, it was good. It was relaxing, and like you said, last weekend was horrible. So I just wanted to come out and do good, and I didn't have the greatest starts until that last main. I actually almost didn't have the whole shot. I ended up with it and just checked out. I watched Bowers go through the whoops as I was in the air, and, you know, just he was closing in a little bit, but I was comfortable with where I was at, and just took that second win and second overall for the weekend. So I turned it around good, and I feel great.
And yes, he does have a smile on his face. Tyler Villopoto, 5-3 main event scores. That gives him third overall. Good to see him on the podium, and he's with Christy Lee.
Tyler, first podium in the main. I talked with you and your crew earlier today. You guys made a lot of changes on the bike. Obviously, you found what you were looking for.
Yeah, you know, for sure. My mechanic, Chad, has just been helping me out so much on and off the track, and had a good night, definitely building from the last few weekends that we've had to deal with a few things. But this weekend's awesome. I'm just going to go home and keep working hard and just try to carry some of this steam throughout the next few rounds, and, you know, it'll be good.
We saw you not only in our AX mains tonight, but also in the lights class as well. That had to be difficult running both classes.
Yeah, you know, it's not too bad just because we had a single night tonight. But from here on out, we'll have back-to-back nights, and it'll be a lot of time on the track. But it'll be good for me, strengthen me for next year. So,
looking ahead to Cedar Park, what's your outlook for that weekend?
Like I said, just trying to build. Each weekend has definitely been progression for me. So just trying to keep going with it and just do better each weekend. And I'd just like to thank my trainer, Charles Dow, Icon Sports. He's been helping me out so much. And everybody that's got me to where I'm at today from WA, thank you, everybody. And the Lord Jesus Christ for keeping me safe and getting me to where I'm at. So thank you.
Looking at the AMSOIL Arena Cross points, Bauer still separating himself. 10 main event victories so far this year. And you look down through the field, we're trying to find those top 10. Dave Genofi still holds that spot, but Kyle White only 3 points behind him. It's getting very close here at AMSOIL Arena Cross. And what a night tonight was. I mean, when we thought it couldn't get any better, it does. Bar banging the entire night long.
We saw some great racing tonight. Like you said, every time I don't believe the racing can get any better, it seems to do it. We had great bracket racing. We had great racing in the LCQs with Desperate Dan maneuvers at the end. And it was cool having Ricky Carmichael here enjoying it, interacting with the fans, showing us more about the Ricky Carmichael road to Supercross, having him up in the booth. I really enjoyed myself. I hope you guys did too.
He made that pick too and broke Tyler Bauer's streak. He's got to say, nah, I'm not letting Ricky do that anymore.
Well, it's funny. He said, I don't want number 8. I'd rather have 0 or 16, which I thought was kind of a, you know, odd thing to say, but maybe there's some truth behind that.
Hey, unlucky for him tonight, but he still comes out the overall champion. What a night of racing. We still have more every week on AMSOIL Arena Cross. Next week, as we look at our TV schedule, Cedar Park, Texas. We're here every week except for 1 week in March. But AMSOIL Arena Cross is where you want to see on speed every week. For Grant Langston, Ricky Carmichael, Christy Lee, I'm Robbie Floyd. Thanks for watching. You can always follow us online at AMSOIL ArenaCross.com, on Twitter at Twitter, or AMSOIL Arena Cross on Facebook. We'll see you next week at Cedar Park, Texas. Thanks for now.